Oh, he's bowled him straight through the gate.
Welcome to Lords for the final of the Bob Willis Trophy. The news from the middle, Essex have won the toss and elected to bowl first. Ben Green and Tom Lemonby, the openers for Somerset, the latter having batted so well his breakout season, his first year in first-class cricket, a couple of centuries along the way. Porter bowling with three slips and a gully. On the way at Lords to start the Bob Willis Trophy final, Porter bowls. Down the leg side to begin. Shout the leg before, close and gone. Lemonby gone for a duck. Cook straight in the book. Somerset lose their first wicket without scoring a run.
Well, that's a big loss. It's a big, big loss. A man in form. Tom Lemonby's been in good form in all formats this year, but he's got to go for a duck.
Cook's now got four slips. Ooh, it's off the outside edge too. The first runs of the final from the blade of Abel down towards the rope at third man. Short cut and out to the boundary for a second four in the over. On top of the bounce there, Abel in complete control. Nice clip that from Abel. Again, gap at mid-wicket, runs away towards the boundary and trickles into the rope. So his third four of the morning, the Somerset skipper, moving to 13. Nice shot to finish there from Green. The first time he's really been able to middle one down the ground. He's tried a couple of times and picked out fielders, but completing that ninth over with his first four of the morning. Green moves to 8, and Somerset 22 for 1.
Well, that's as good a shot as we've seen all morning, really. It's NAYC, National Association of Young Cricketers. 1984. It's Ben Green clips away nicely off his hips. He looks strong to the leg side and picks up a boundary.
Oh, that's excellent timing again. You're absolutely right. Anything off his pads, he's been pretty good.
Beard to continue. Smashed off the back foot. Absolute beauty. Short of a length, a little bit of width. Punched through the covers. A little bit like Matt Floyd in his pomp.
Yeah, very similar actually. Good morning, Niall. Lovely shot that. Oh, chance for catch down the leg side. That is taken. What a spectacular grab from Adam Wheater. Diving full strength, one-handed, just off the ground. Tom Abel clearly gloving that delivery from Aaron Beard. And Somerset are two down.
Wheater took a really good grab, and it's a big breakthrough for Essex.
Nicely clipped by Byrom. Half stopped by the fielder, but that will run away down this famous Lord's slope. First boundary for the number four. Edged and dropped straight through the man at fourth slip. Went down very quickly, stuck out a left hand and barely touched it. But that is a missed chance. Tough one granted. Essex will feel that should have been taken. Oh, he's bowled him straight through the gate and down the hill. Sam Cook deservedly gets his second wicket and Ben Green is bowled for 24.
Oh, that's an absolute beauty. Top class bowling. He's worked over the batsman Ben Green. His stay has come to an end and Somerset have lost the third with 52 on the board.
Steered off the back foot by Bartlett to get off the mark with a boundary. Perhaps not completely in control of the stroke, but all the way along the ground. 58 for 3. Again, steered down towards third man. Second boundary in the over. Picked up nicely there. Byrom flipping through just forward a square, racing out to the rope in front of the grandstand. He moves to 19, 67 for 3.
Boy, he's hit that well, hasn't he?
Couple of slips in a gully. Beard operating around the wicket. Lovely shot, Byrom. Just about the shot of the morning. crashing into the rope in front of our commentary position. He moves to 26, 77 for three, Somerset.
Yeah, spot on. Shot of the day so far. Beautiful, really, with a short one, a good bounce of the ball before, and then to climb onto the front foot.
It's full again. Clips nicely through mid-wicket. Up the hill. Will it trickle into the rope? It will. Back-to-back boundaries. Byrom driving again, out to the boundary. Three in the over. On that front foot, a pristine square drive. He's 34, 85 for three now, Somerset.
Yeah, and how quickly just one bad over has just changed this session, really. 85 for three is about on as even.
Byrom again through mid-wicket. Perhaps a misfield. Out towards the rope in front of the mound stand. Very good batting this from the left-hander. He's 39 from just 42 deliveries, 90 for three. Byrom leaning on the front foot, defending behind point to complete the first session of this Bob Willis Trophy final here at Lords. Somerset going to the interval at 90 for three. Byrom 39 from just 45 balls, and Bartlett 8 not out from 23 up the other end.
Oh, beats the outside edge. What a start it's been in this session. Four maidens in a row. Edge and taken straight into the safe hands at first slip of Sir Alistair Cook. So the pressure built up has resulted in a wicket. George Bartlett gone for 12. It's 94 for four.
Somerset, I reckon, be a little bit disappointed. Probably lost one more than they would like. Essex probably making the running, but it's been a decent game so far. Good contest between bat and ball, as you would expect this time of year. Eddie Byrom's looked good. Aggressive approach, been very positive in his foot movement. Looking to latch on to anything too full this afternoon.
Yeah, all three of these Essex seamers have enjoyed the conditions today. I think Sam Cook has bowled as well as any of them, has looked incisive. Spells from the nursery end and pavilion end. Porter has bowled from the pavilion end exclusively, but all three have managed to keep a Somerset batsman under lock and key. So it's a young Somerset lineup in the absence of James Hildreth. Lots of talented young men. Tom Abel, the oldest at 26, so plenty for them to learn about the game and progress. They've got a good man in Marcus Trescothick to learn from. Lovely. What a nice way to go through to a half century for Eddie Byrom. That was just push time beautifully down the ground. The raise of the bat. You can hear the cheers from the Somerset dressing room just below us where we're commentating from, and loud cheers rang out there. A bit of bad news. I think you can probably see the ground staff hovering in the distance there. They've resolutely stayed by the covers as if they're anticipating a bit more juice. I can hear patter of rain on the wooden turrets above us. We're commentating from the right-hand turret of the old pavilion. And it's definitely just started to drizzle again. To the point at which the umpires have said enough, and I suspect that may well be it for the day. It's been a rain-interrupted day, a disappointing day from that regard, but a good one for Eddie Byrom.
Somerset have moved along to 119 for four. Eddie Byrom, 51 not out. Stephen Davis giving him good support.
And we are go on morning two. Ooh, first ball hitting the seam, moving away, beating the outside edge. Doesn't get more spot on than that. Soft hands through the cordon and down to the rope for four. Again, using the outside portion of the bat, Davies. The second time he's profited there this morning for a second boundary, moving into the 20s. Two slips and no gully now. That's a good shot from Davies. Square drive out towards the rope. It's third four. One and two. 25 he moves. Somerset. 1-32 for four. Three catches waiting. Two slips in a gully. Oh, there it is. A little feather from Davies through to the gloves of Wheater. He's gone for 27. And after a lot of hard work from the Essex Seamers this morning, they've picked up their fifth wicket.
They've probed Essex, and they've got the breakthrough they deserve. 139 for five. Davis gone 27.
Nicely clipped by Overton as Porter strays a little bit to leg, and it should run away down the hill and does for four.
And this is why it's just a decent pitch. It's not easy for batting, as it shouldn't be this time of year, but if you miss your line and length, you can still put the ball away.
Edged but short of second slip and will fly away. Looks like it's hurt second slip as well. Is that Simon Harmer? Usually is in that position, and he went low to his right. No chance. Looks like he's taken one on the end of the finger. Porter now from the nursery end for the first time this game. Looks good there, Eddie Byrom. That was the shot that took him to 50 yesterday, the ninth of his boundaries yesterday, his best of the day, and that's a repeat stroke off the first ball from Porter. Not a million miles away from gully as Overton drives firmly in the air.
Clipped away by Craig Overton, second time he's played that shot. And for the second time, the ball is running away down the slope here at Lords for a boundary. He moves on to 17 not out off just 21 balls. Short again, and Byrom takes full advantage, rocks back onto his back foot, pulls away, no man out on the boundary. Another boundary for him, he's up to 73. Sweeping this time, lovely shot, good shot selection. Once again, no man out on the leg side, and he has found the boundary, successive boundaries for Eddie Byrom.
Well, that's wonderful batting. Somerset, 178 for five. You'll be thinking, right, play well to lunch here. Add another 40, 50 runs. Keep these five wickets in hand, really well placed.
Clipped away by Craig Overton. This might be another boundary. It is going to be another boundary. So a good few balls for Somerset. That is three boundaries in a row. Getting a bit of momentum now, 182 for five.
So all of a sudden, Essex on the back foot, under real pressure for the first time in this fixture. Somerset really gaining momentum.
Oh, that's a big LBW shout. Got to be out, surely. Very full. No. Not out, says Rob Bailey. That was very full, wasn't it? It looked quite straight from where we are, high up on the pavilion. And Aaron Beard certainly felt that should have been given out. Hands on heads now for a lot of Essex fielders. Played away by Byrom through the leg side. That's going to be another boundary. Very nicely clipped off his legs for four. Down leg side. Byrom takes the single. Just turning that one around the corner. The 200 is up for Somerset. 200 for five.
Got a slip and a short leg. Playing that with nice soft hands, Overton. Racing towards the boundary. Might have done enough to reach the rope. And it does. Inside edge. That's four runs for Overton. Overton carving out towards point. Struck it well. And struck it well enough for four. Into the 40s. Leaping straight onto the back foot and giving it plenty. Nice way to bounce back after a false stroke the ball before. Somerset 2-1-9 for five. Overton now into the 40s. He's 42 as well. Oh, shout for leg before from around the wicket. Would have needed to have straightened. It's turned down. Harmer liked it more than Cook did at first slip, it must be said. But no, of course, no reviews at their disposal in this form of the game, so that's that. Overton down the leg side is able to just help it on its way. Four runs moving to 48. Just a little tickle on that Cook delivery, but it was enough to beat the squarish long leg. And there it is. A very nice half century for Craig Overton. Recognised accordingly by his teammates. One more chance to reach his ton before lunch. Last ball of the session. Byrom defends carefully, watchfully, out to extra cover. So he'll have a sandwich on 97 from 177 balls. We're at lunch here at Lord's on the second day of the Bob Willis Trophy final. Somerset 233 for 5.
It's certainly a first-class century in the book, and this will be his third. But I'm sure doing it in a Bob Willis Trophy final against a top side like the county champions Essex will mean a hell of a lot to him. He's pushed that down the ground. Could this be the century? Is this running away to the boundary? It is. Eddie Byrom has got to three figures. Big celebration, big cheers from the Somerset balcony. Takes his helmet off. Well played, young man, as he has delivered when it really mattered. Top edge. Is this going to be a chance? Asked the Cook running back. No. Can't get there. So some luck for Byrom. First time he's played a full shot in quite a while, actually. More runs down the leg side. Scored at a good rate. 250 up now. It's got a bit darker, I'm afraid.
It's got very gloomy very quickly. You can see those shadows now around the fielder's feet from the floodlights. But I'm afraid the rain has just started to fall.
Yeah, that's it, they're going off. It was actually Craig Overton, the non-striker, who just started walking off before the umpires made a decision. I think they were pretty keen to get off quickly too, and now it's coming down fairly heavily. So that means we're going to have a bit of a break with Somerset. 255 for 5 of 84 overs in their first innings.
So Porter does have the second new ball. Oh, shout for leg before. Has to be close and given. That's exactly what Essex needed with this second new ball. It's taken three deliveries for Porter to go past the inside edge of Overton, who falls for 66. Somerset 266 for 6. Off the back foot, carving. And carving nicely is Byrom. Out towards the rope at point in front of the grandstand. He moves to 117. Just taking advantage of a bit of width there from Cook and dispatching him. 270 for 6. Oh, a shout for leg before. And he's given. Byram's gone for 117. Breakthroughs in consecutive overs with the second new ball. A fine innings comes to an end. Somerset 270 for 7, Athens.
He leaves a memory for the winter. It's the kind of innings that people will take notice of against the county champions at the home of cricket in a showpiece game. He's played beautifully. Eddie Byrom has gone now, though. 117 and the second new ball working for Essex.
Oh, what a pickup that is from Lewis Gregory. That is going to go all the way for 6 on the longer side of the boundary over towards the grandstand. That was an awesome pickup. He's gone for the pickup again. He's missed it and he's been given out LBW. Lewis Gregory turns immediately, not too disappointed with the decision, and Sam Cook has his fifer.
Yeah, and well deserved. He's been the pick of the bowlers right throughout. I don't reckon Lewis Gregory would be unhappy for being out, but I reckon the way that he was looking to play just says that they feel Somerset, they've got a decent score.
Lovely shot that from Josh Davey, number 9 batsman. Glorious straight drive, and that is going to reach the boundary. First boundary for him.
Yeah, well played. Porter trying to get it up there for the nick, so you risk the odd boundary. That's well played.
And that is a lovely pull shot, just a short arm jab. That's going to run away down the hill as well and go for successive boundaries. Classy.
What's that? 291, getting close to that 300. That is an excellent shot.
Nice clip that. Through mid-wicket, in the gap. And down towards the tavern stand for four.
Brings up the 300 for Somerset. What a number that was. Ben Green spoke about the magical 250 last night. Well, 301 with two wickets left. Absolutely fantastic position.
Oh, shout for leg before, and he's given. Leach has gone for three. Harmer into the attack and gets himself his first wicket. Somerset 301 for nine. Still a little bit of time left tonight. If they can get this final wicket. Oh, threw him. Bowled first ball. So Somerset are all out for 301. Brooks gone first ball. Davey, the not out man on 17.
Essex fought back with that second new ball, taking plenty of wickets. Sam Cook, fantastic. Five wicket haul, wonderful, wonderful spell. Bowled brilliantly with good pace, good skill. Kept the attack going. Porter Bowell, he took 2 for 85, but Sam Cook was the pick. 5 for 76 off 32 with 10 mates.
That will be stumps